Hey, what's up guys? Andrew here. Today we're looking at the HP Stream 14. This one's the Walmart exclusive, model number 14-CB171WM. It retails for $219, features an Intel Celeron N4020 processor, 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of eMMC storage, 14-inch HD screen, and you also get an Intel HD graphics card. FYI, this whole review, or most of it, is going to be recorded with the iPhone 12 Pro Max running at 4K at 30 frames per second, as well as the audio. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. All right guys, let's get started. The design of the HP Stream 14 looks pretty stylish. It comes in at 3.17 pounds and it feels pretty durable. There's hardly any kind of display flex. Look at this. Let me show you the keyboard as well. See, hardly any kind of flex. Pretty well-built machine for its price point. Let's look at the bottom here. Oh, by the way, it weighs 3.17 pounds, so it's easy to take on the go. And you got your two bottom facing speakers on the front. By default, this laptop comes with Windows 10 in S mode. However, I highly recommend switching out of S mode for a better experience, unless you want a crippled operating system. To switch out of S mode, you want to go to your settings, update and security, scroll down the left where it says activation, and then go right here towards the middle where it says switch to Windows 10 home. It'll just be a much better experience in my opinion. This laptop features the Intel Celeron N4020, which is a standard dual-core processor running at 1.1 GHz, with a single-core burst up to 2.8 GHz. Now, this is a standard processor meant for light-duty web browsing, multitasking, word processing. Just don't expect crazy performance out of it, and you'll be perfectly fine for schoolwork. Alright guys, take a look at the ports here on the left side of the HP Stream 14. Starting from the left, you got your security lock slot, HDMI, most likely a regular HDMI, I doubt it's HDMI 2.0. Two USB 3.0s, a standard USB 2, headset microphone jack combo, SD card reader, and your power status LED indicator. Looking towards the back, there's nothing back here. Now let's go to the right side of the laptop. All you got is your power AC power charging port and the status LED indicator. With the purchase of the HP Stream 14, you're getting Microsoft Office 365 free for 1 year. They're now calling it Microsoft 365. You're basically getting Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, Outlook, and OneDrive for free for 1 year. For the OneDrive, you get 1 TB drive storage. And for the Skype, you get 60 minutes a month, I believe, for free. This is definitely gonna save students some money in the first year. All right, guys, we're gonna test out the web browsing performance on HP Stream 14. See how smooth it is. This is the MSN website. So far, it feels very smooth. FYI, I do have a lot going on here. I got the CNN tab open, as well as the Fox, ESPN. A little slight delay, look at that, see? This laptop features an Elon trackpad. I kind of wish they went with a Windows Precision trackpad. However, at this price point, you can't nitpick too much. With that being said, two-finger scrolling, multi-touch, and gestures were pretty on point. I didn't have any issues. Hey, what's up guys, Andrew here. Test out the webcam on the HP Stream 14. This is actually in 360p at 16:9. And the quality is actually kind of horrible in my opinion. It's 360p, so just don't expect excellent quality. So this laptop features a 14-inch screen with a resolution of 1366 by 768. So it's an HD screen that's also glossy, so it can be kind of glossy against, especially when towards bright window or lighting. Let me show you guys a sample. Besides that, this screen is actually pretty decent at this price point. Color accuracy is decent. Well, I would say a little bit less than average, but that's kind of expected at this price point. Let me show you guys here how far it goes down. That's maximum. Let me do a side angle test here. Let's look at the viewing angles. Pretty decent viewing angles as well. Let me show you guys some of the text here on this HD screen. Here goes some of the specs on this laptop and the features. The text quality is not too bad either.
The 64 GB eMMC flash storage is pretty quick in my opinion compared to a standalone traditional hard drive. For the read speed, you're getting 308 megabytes a second, and for the write speed, you're getting 188 megabytes a second. Next up is battery performance. HP claims you can get up to 11 hours of usage, but I've yet to see that figure. They probably tested that with the screen on super low and video playback over and over. However, in my real-world testing, I got around 6 to 7.5 hours in usage, and that's with light web browsing, word processing, Netflix, YouTube here and there, Now, your usage may vary. It's just depending on the applications you're using and what you plan on doing with it.
All right, so we're gonna push some 4K content here and do a quick test, pushing the Intel HD graphics card to the max. Yes, I know it's a 1366 by 768 HD panel, but it just gives you an idea of how the Intel HD graphics card is working. So far, very smooth and no hiccups. Wow, that just looks breathtaking. Look at that. Wow, that's amazing.
The keyboard's pretty well spaced out for a 14-inch laptop. The keys are also comfortable, you get decent key travel, and the overall layout is pretty solid. Only con here, there's not a backlit keyboard. There are two bottom front facing speakers towards the front, and the overall sound quality and levels are adequate. Alright guys, to sum up the review of the HP Stream 14, this one's the Walmart exclusive. This one features the Intel Celeron N4020, which is a decent Celeron processor aimed for like light duty activity, web browsing, word processing, watching Netflix and videos here and there. You also get 4GB of RAM and 64GB of eMMC flash storage, which is pretty quick. This laptop also boots up in about 25 to 35 seconds. Battery performance was also pretty good. I was getting around 6 to 7 hours with medium screen brightness with light duty usage. Now at $219, you can't really complain too much with this laptop. It just has a good design, it's lightweight, affordable, just has a decent processor as well for light duty productivity tasks, and it's just not too much to complain about at this price point. I highly recommend this laptop for students that are on a strict budget, that want it for casual activity like web browsing and just light duty schoolwork. It's going to fit the job and get the work done. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to share, like, and subscribe. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.